Hello and welcome back to another tutorial of Tableau from Practical IT. In this tutorial we will learn about conditional formatting and we will also see how we can apply KPIs. So basically, what is a conditional formatting? Conditional formatting in Tableau can be achieved with the use of parameters. Parameters can act as a placeholder for a value on which a condition will be called. So we will see by a very basic example. I will give you 2-3 example on conditional formatting and KPIs. So first example would be like I have a category on my row shelf, then I have a subcategory next to it, then I have my profit measure onto text level. So in this table view structure I have a data categorized by category, then by subcategory. So you have seen, you may see there are values of positive profits and negative profits. So I want to apply a conditional formatting on this table view. The conditional formatting would be like I need all the profits that is less than a particular value to be red and above particular value to be a green. It's like a center point. I will decide a center point. Let's say I decide a center point of 3000. Below 3000 I want all the profits to be appear in a red and all the profits above 3000 to be appear in a green or whatever color. So what I will do, I will drag this profit measure onto color marks. You will see here we have received a color palette on this profit measure, right? So what I will do, I will go click on this drop down pill of profit measure, edit color. Under edit color I would like to click on advance, then I would have my starting point this, then end point this, decided by the data, right, itself. We will not change it. And center point, likewise I said I want center point 3000 at 3000 at 3000 profit. This is my center point. Below 3000 I will get some particular color, and after 3000 point I will get some other color, right? So what I will do, I will also use a stepped color. Currently by default it is in a 5. By default it has stepped color, it has no stepped color. So I will create a stepped color by clicking on this checkbox, then this would be highlighted into a step. So I will decrease it by 2 level. Why 2 level? Just because we are applying only 2 conditions, right? So what I will do, you also can change the palette of this measure. Click on this, make it red, and on the this icon make it let's say you make it green, right? Then apply, then okay. You will see below 3000 we have got profit in red, and above 3000 we have got profit in green, right? So what you will do, under mark section click on this drop down, change it to square. The moment you change it to square, the whole color will be applied to each cell of this table, right? Each cell of this table. Let's say I want to modify my center point. Let's say I want to modify my center point at 10,000. Below 10,000 I will get this value, and after 10,000 I will get this color, right? Below 10,000 we are getting red color, and after 10,000 we are getting green color. So this was our basic example of conditional formatting. In my next example I will include a KPI. By the way, what do you mean by KPI? KPI is basically, you call it key progress indicators. A key performance indicator is a measurable value that shows how a company or a particular पर्टिकुलर सेगमेंट और ए कैटेगरी इज़ परफॉर्मिंग और इज़ अचीविंग की बिजनेस ऑब्जेक्टिव्स. सो आई विल इंक्लूड की KPI इन दिस एग्जाम्पल. सो वॉट आई विल डू, लेट मी फर्स्ट ड्रैग लेट मी ड्रैग सेगमेंट ऑन माई सेगमेंट टू माई कॉलम्स शेल्फ, देन ड्रैग माई सब कैटेगरी, नो नॉट सब, सब कैटेगरी ऑन टू रो शेल्फ. आई विल गेट दिस स्ट्रक्चर. सो आई विल ड्रैग माई प्रॉफिट ऑन टू टेक्स्ट, राइट, ऑन टेक्स्ट लेवल. सो हेयर आई वुड लाइक टू इम्प्लीमेंट अ कंडीशन. आई वुड इम्प्लीमेंट अ कंडीशन हेयर लाइक below some amount of profit I must get this color, and between some value I want to have this color, and after this color, basically I want to say I want to have more than two criterias. What will I do? Let's say below 3000 I would like to have a red color, and above 3000 and less than 8000 I would have amber color. Then after above 8000 I would have a green color. So this is possible only by creating a calculated field, right? So what I will go here, then click on create calculated field. Create calculated field, I will give it a name. Let me call it a profit condition, profit underscore condition, right? Now I will apply my condition here. I said if sum of profit is less than equal to 3000, then I would like to have a red color, right? I also like to apply another condition. Sum of profit is let's say less than equal to 8000, then I would have amber color, right? Else at the end I would have green color, right? These three conditions I have given, and I will end this function with end. So what I'm saying here, if my profit is below 3000, I want to have a red color. My profit between 3000 above 3000 and 8000, I would like to have amber color, and above 8000 I would have green color. So here the word that I have used, red, amber, green, this is just for give them a color, right? This is for only for color purpose. This has no meaning in this calculation, only a customized color purpose, right? So what I will do, I will just create on apply, then okay. I will drag this profit onto colors, right? What will happen? It will change according to the colors, according to the condition that I have given, but I don't want this. What I will do, I will click on this drop down from my marks card. I will take it to the shape, right? Let me drag it little bit so that the shape and the values are fit according into a cell, right? Now my shape and measure values are corresponding to each other, are parallel to each other, right? So what I will do, I will drag again this newly created calculation field onto shape. The moment you drag your shape, you will get these three icons, for amber color this, for green, for red this, right? I will change this into a KPI icon. Just click on this drop down, edit shape, come over here, select this. For amber it means it is average, like it's like average. For green I want to include, that's green means it the performance is well, so I want to have a upward arrow. For red it means performance is down, so I want to have down arrow, right? Apply, then okay. So these icons have been decided by our calculated field that we have created, right? Less than 3000 we have a red icon, between 3000 and 8000 we have this amber icon, and after 8000 we have green triangle, right? So what I can do, I can simply go to this color, edit. You can change this color amber. For amber I will select, let's say you have this color. For amber you can pick this color. For green you can pick this green color. For red you can pick this red color, right? Apply, then okay. If you see here, these icons have been placed inside the cell of my measure, each measure, right? So this is showing, this visualization is totally depend upon my calculation profit comparison, right, that we have created. So if you want to include only this icon, your KPI icon, what you can do is simply take this profit measure off from this visualization and adjust its width to little bit to the left. Now you also can view that, you also can take this view in this way, right? So this is our second example, and in third example what I will do, I will give you a very good example in this. Let's say we have a not category, we have a profit measure and we have a subcategory, right? Let me sort it. So this is my profit, this is my profit by descending order, right? So what I will do, I will create a dual axis chart. I will create a dual axis view. So my the secondary axis would be for a label. I mean, this would be my first axis and my secondary axis would be label. Label means it will appear here. This is my profit. I want to include a some extra value in this profit. I want to create a calculated field that will increase my profit by some amount. See, this profit has 55,680 rupees, 618 rupees. So what I will do, I will increase this my profit by 1000, let's say by $1000. So what will happen, so this bar will increase little bit ahead. So I will include that calculated field in this view as a dual axis, so that this can be turned into a label for this bar, and later on this bar would be converted into a KPI shape, right? So what I will do, I will include a two conditional formatting over here. Sorry, I will create a two calculated field. First I will take a positive profit. Let me give it a positive name, positive positive profit, right? We will include abs function, absolute function. What it will do, it will convert all the negative profit into a positive, right? Sum of profit. Apply, then okay. I also need a positive profit that will be little bit ahead, little bit extra of this positive profit. So what I will do, I will say positive profit extra. Simply I will include absolute of sum of profit, right? I will include plus, let's say 700 values, so that this measure can be used as label to be placed above this bar, right? So you will see in a moment. Let me drag my positive profit onto color shelf. So these last three values is my last three four values are my negative. So I have included the, I have converted this into an absolute value just because we can apply our positive profit extra as a level on this bar. You will see in a moment. Let me drag my additional calculation field next to it. So I will convert this into a dual axis chart. Right click, synchronize, so that both the axes must be in a synchronized. For the first axis I want to make it a bar, right? For the second axis, what I will do for this axis, I will convert this into a shape, right? The moment you convert this into a shape, you will get the shape icon above the bar. So from this I will also introduce a calculated field that will tell me what it will tell, either profit or loss, up or down, right? If sum of profit is greater than zero, then it means it is up, else DW and down, right? So I will include up, then keyword is missing. So I will include this calculation field onto my shape. Let me drag this calculation field all to my shape. So I will get two shape, down and up, right? So I would change this shape as per their meaning. Click on this for down shape. Come over here, field. For down shape we need this icon. For up shape we need this icon, right? Apply, then OK. What I will do, I will change the color of this icon. Just click on this, edit, for positive. For down icon, you will drag your calculation onto secondary colored shelf axis. You will get two colors now. For down, what you will do, for down, take a red color, apply, then OK. And for up, you can pick green shade, right? Apply, then OK, right? So here what you are seeing, these last three profit was in negative. We have kept this bar facing to the right side so that I can include my KPI icons on this value, right? So basically these three bars is my negative. I have included +700 just because this is the calculation field that I have created. +700, what do you mean by +700? It means I can get some extra space over this bar. This icon has been created by including +700 in my calculation field so that I can place it above my previous bar, on my first axis, primary axis bar, right? So if you hover your mouse, you don't need any tooltip. Just go to the secondary axis tooltip, remove everything, right? The moment I hover my mouse on the bar, I must get profit. I must get my real profit. So click on this, my first axis tooltip, remove this profit. In order to include profit into this tooltip, what you will do, just drag your profit onto detail shelf. Now click onto this tooltip, insert it from here, sum of profit. So we will give a name to this profit. What you can do, just Control X, just copy this, Control X, type it profit, give some space, then paste it. Okay, we have included our profit into a tooltip, right? You can see the profit is now appearing. If you see here, it will show you the real profit, right? The formula we applied ABS just because to change the change the direction of this bar, right? Just to change the direction of this bar to the rightward. This is the only logic we have applied. You also can remove the show order from here of secondary axis. So you can change the view of this. You can change the color of this bar, primary axis. You can take this color, apply then, okay, right. Now you can see this looks me very beautiful, right? Isn't it? So I hope you have learned something in this tutorial. So I am keeping this video as short as simple. So I will see you in my next video. Till then, you stay healthy and stay safe. Bye bye.